5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. It would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister. The look it was giving me.
What are you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better. Sheriff, Zia!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show. Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you this evening. Remember, if you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email, wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. On Sunday, I'm going to be having Woody return to the show. Him and I are going to talk about the lights, and I have a couple guests lined up for Sunday, too, as well. Tonight's an interesting night. If you don't have the covers over your head now, I might want to go ahead and warn you. You might want to put them over your head. This is a very, very interesting night. I'll be welcoming Johnny on here shortly, and Johnny's going to talk about a logging incident. He had asked me if it was okay if he talked about an additional encounter he had with something that was non-Sasquatch oriented, and I was open to listen to what he had to say, and it was fascinating, very, very fascinating to hear this other entity he ran into. But the Sasquatch encounter is very interesting. And I think a lot of these loggers, when they're out there logging these areas, they run into stuff like this and they never talk about it. So it's great that Johnny is able to come on and share what happened to him and what happened to the logging crew. I want to jump right into it tonight. Johnny, welcome to the show. Thank you for being here tonight, man.
Well, thank you very much. It's good to be here.
Let's jump into the strange encounter. What were you doing at that time, and what did you guys see?
It was actually just two of us, and we were actually looking to move somewhere. So we were like, let's go check out a lot of places. So, you know, we drove right to Bozeman, Montana, and I love that town. It was real, just a real nice. It almost has like a Colorado feel. It's the one place in Montana that doesn't have that typical Montana feel where you step back 50 years in time. And then we went to Missoula, another town. I really liked that place. And we were mountain biking around there. And then we were heading up to Glacier. And I'm thinking I'm pretty sure it was the Flathead National Forest. I mean, I thought it was a state forest at the time, but like I said, we never even knew. You could just go, and you probably can't do it these days. This is the early 90s. But you could literally just, you know, we would park in a ditch and leave our car for 2-3 days, go back. We never had any problems. You know, nowadays it probably might get tagged. So I don't know how strict they've gotten, but you know, we would go and find these cool places and just go out. So I'm pretty sure it was the Flathead National Forest, and someone had, you know, in Missoula told us about these, you know, these awesome waterfalls, and they kind of gave us directions, and we found what we thought was it. Now I've discovered there's, you know, all types of these little rivers, but it was a, you know, probably 8 to 10 foot across river, just filled with rocks, and it just went all the way up the mountain. So there was, we did find a kind of a trail. So we parked, went down the trail, and then it just stopped right by the river. And then we just kept, we had all our gear, we just kept hiking up and up and up. And then there was probably, it might have been like a 50-foot waterfall, maybe a little bit taller. So we had to walk around. And at the where we were at, it was kind of an open ravine, a nice open area. So we walked around, went up, and we're basically on a 50-foot-plus ridge looking over this nice little valley where the river went down and into with a nice open. So like, this is a perfect place to camp. So we set up our camp and, you know, got the tent set up and we just got some stuff. And like, let's just keep going up the river and explore. So we kept walking, going up, and it just, it was like we're in a different world. It was just like a different planet. It was so beautiful. Just all these little waterfalls and, you know, the land was as it has been forever, you know, just untouched, pristine, gorgeous. So we keep walking and walking and, you know, after a couple hours, we were like, all right, we should probably head back and, you know, get some food to eat and get ready to settle in for the night. So we're starting to walk down on the river, and after a little bit, we could hear the branches snapping. And, you know, another thing that we hadn't noticed was it was real quiet. We weren't hearing anything. But, you know, we're just looking at everything, taking everything in. Sometimes you just don't notice that stuff. But now all of a sudden we hear these branches break, like that's, you know, something's behind us. So we sped up, and the more we sped up, the more it sped up, and it was getting closer. And we're like, all of a sudden we're freaked out. We're like, what if it's a bear? You know, because there's grizzlies, brown bears. So we start screaming and yelling, go away, bear, go away, bear, da da da. And the more we yelled, the closer it got. So we're like, okay, we gotta speed up. So we really started cooking down the hill. And there was like a nice 15-foot or so waterfall. And we jumped down the side of that as quick as we could and got in a little open area. So we're just going to wait and see what it is. And we're basically like, if it's a bear, we've just got to take off running as fast as we can. And we'll run straight down to the car. It's probably, you know, 2 or 3 miles away. So we're waiting. We hear something coming closer. It's getting real close. And we look up, and it's a young kid. It's a kid our age, early 20s, with a rifle, standing at the top of the ridge looking down at us. So it kind of startled us, but not really, because, you know, back then, people with guns, the last thing you think is they're going to do anything to you. It's a hunter. So, like, hey, you know, what's going on, da da da. He's like, how are you? And he's just looking at us. We're looking at him. We're like, are you hunting? He's like, well, kind of. And, you know, what are you guys doing up here? We're like, we're just, you know, we set up a camp down this way. We're just going to, you know, stay here for a couple days. And he's like, oh, okay. He's like, well, I'll walk down with you guys. I'll walk to your camp and, you know, take a breather and hang out. So we ended up going down, and we're like, we're going to set up a fire. He's like, well, you know, make sure you don't cook here. We're like, yeah. So we ended up going back up a little bit, eating some dinner, and then he starts talking. He's like, you know, look over. So you can see the mountain range, the other mountain range, all the way across the valley. And he's like, you see that strip? And there was a huge strip of clear cut, you know, just a massive path where they cut all these trees. You know, maybe it was, I don't know, 100 yards up and down. It was a huge path. He's like, you know, that was already cut. He's like, and they're just starting one that's going to be lower than it. And he starts telling us what had happened. So it would have been, I think, 2 days before, they had taken a bulldozer. They bulldozed a road up to where they were going to start the clear cutting. And then they brought all the equipment up. And it's probably, I don't know, whatever the crew was, 8 to 10 guys. And they're getting ready to clear out more. And they spent the whole morning doing that. And as they were having lunch, all of a sudden rocks start getting thrown at them. And they think it's one of the other, you know, loggers playing, you know, just messing around with them. So they're starting, you know, who's doing, you know, knock it off, da 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 da. And all of a sudden they're going, like, wait, everyone's here. And they're kind of like, who's throwing rocks at us? Now, like, none of them got hit, but it was close enough where, you know, if they get hit, they're going to get hurt. They just were like, it just kind of startled. What's going on? So